Hi, my name is Rebecca, and I am going to do a documentary slash true story of how I started out on YouTube and my story from there. First video I've ever did on YouTube, and what I did before I started using a camera. I used to make fan videos for Harry Potter. I did that on the Rockin' Poppin' 33 account. That was my very first time I ever made. When I first started out before YouTube, I used to get on my parents' computer all the time, and all I would do is just take a bunch of random clips and just put it together, and then I just put music on there, and then long behold, I created this music video type thing, and I had so many on that computer. And then when late 2011 came around, I discovered YouTube. And when I discovered YouTube, I saw all these people uploaded their creations, and there was so many great creations on there. I really wanted to upload mine and see what kind of feedback I got. But it takes a long time in order to build up to the point where people actually notices your videos. So one day I decided to upload all my Harry Potter videos that I made on my computer, and when I did that, lo and behold, a month later, there was at least 2,000 people who watched that video, and I had so much great feedback from it. And ever since then, I started just continuing on with YouTube and started doing videos and doing what I love doing. Normally, till I think it was like mid 2012, I think it was. I started doing brass videos, and I made a whole new YouTube cultural term myself. It was basically because I needed to start out small somewhere. I had to start out small, and when I did, I started off with Bratz Dolls. I know that sounds really weird, especially coming from me, but yeah. So I started off with Bratz videos because it was smaller, it was easier to learn from your mistakes, and it was a lot more easier for me because normally I didn't really have much people as friends when I was in elementary school. I didn't really have a lot of friends to do videos with, so what I did was I just created my own, and when I did, it created this big mess of Bratz videos.
Oh my god, don't scare me like that. Oh, sorry. Sorry, I didn't mean to startle you, you know? Okay.
And it was the most, to me, I thought it was the most coolest thing ever, because my ideas were coming into life, but through dolls. It was a little weird. Right now, I'm like thinking, wow, that was a dumb idea, and I was still on the internet. But I don't care, because what it did, it helped me build on. You learn from it. And once you learn from something very small like that, and just take bits by bits each time you go along, it builds up to a bigger experience for you. Maybe early 2013, I begin, well, it was normally late 2012, and I started, like, it was during the summer of 2012, to say that. I think it was during the summer of 2012. I started actually using myself in my videos. Like, I mean, I used some of myself in my videos back in, like, 2011 and 2010. I use myself as in my vlogs, but I never really did acting. I tried doing acting before, but I am a terrible actress. I mean, if I can try, I probably can be, but right now, no. I am not a good actress. I started doing more videos with my friends and started getting into more of that. I want to show you some, like, in this whole video, there's gonna be like different videos of me and some other old stuff that I did. And what I did in the videos with my friends, we just goofed off, did skits. Me and my old friend Kenzie, we did a series together, at least we used to, and it worked out really well. Well, to us it did, but right now I'm thinking back on it and I'm like, what
I
did
need
you
that.
do?
We just wanted to
Oh yeah, we're having a swim party.
Yeah, and we just took showers, so that's why our hair is wet. We're in our pajamas. It was just 8 D's. So we're getting hot though.
To us, it was pretty cool. Like, I don't know, it was cool to us. And so later on, I started actually doing little films and stuff. I started getting used to the camera and getting used to my film software that I use to edit everything up, which is Windows Movie Maker, of course. I used to have an actual decent movie maker, which actually I used to make music on. And it was so awesome because I started getting into the music software stuff and I started making these, little beats and stuff with it. Next thing you know, I started making music with my computer. Which I thought that was so awesome. And so I uploaded some of my stuff on YouTube. The Kidz Bop stuff. Well, at a very young age, I used to love that, and one day I was playing with the, kind of like the volume frequency or whatever, that you can change the voice up and down, and you can make it sound like a man, you can make it sound like a chipmunk or a woman. So what I did was, I took the voice of Selena Gomez and turned it into a man. So Selena Gomez is now a man. And then I did like a little kids version, of I Thought I Lost You with Miley Cyrus and John Travolta from the movie Bolt. I used to love that song so much. I don't know why. I just did. Like, I was just like the most favorite song when I was a few years younger than I was now. It feels like forever. Like, it felt like just yesterday this happened. So, then later on, I started doing actual stuff with my camera, like with people. I remember Taylor was one of my projects that I did, my best friend Taylor.
You're not alone, together we stand. I'll be by your side, you know I'll take your hand. When it gets cold and it feels like the end, there's no place to go, you know I won't give in. No, I won't give in.
She's awesome. I'm so glad that she'd been part of that video. It was more of a message for her to give out to people, and I used her as my project. And it was so cool because she sat there with me while I was editing it, and she was actually pretty amazed by it. And a lot of people today, they look at me and they go, Becca, one day we're going to see your name in a big motion picture film. And I'm like, I'm dreaming of that day. Like, it's one of my dreams to be a film director or producer, anything in the film industry, I want to be.
The truth, I want to shelter you, but with the beast inside, there's nowhere we can hide. No matter what we breed, we still are made of greed.
come. This is my kingdom come. Kingdom come.
Either it's an editor, a producer, a director, a writer, I don't care. I just want to be part of that industry. And I hope someday I'll make it there. And, you know, it's a long passion for me, and I love doing it, and I've been doing it for a while now. I know I'm not a professional, but I sure do love doing it, and I want to keep going. And same thing goes for my art. I love art. Like, it's one of my passions as well. And, you know, I'm a visionary. Let's call it that way. I want to put my mind in so much work and put emotion through it. I want people to feel what I felt when I was making that video. I want them to see in my eyes of what I was trying to put through. Show people of where I've started and where I've ended up. I love looking back on this because there's people in my past who try to make me stop what I love doing. I'm still standing here making videos on my laptop and my new Nikon camera, which I need batteries for. But I love doing what I'm doing, and I want to keep doing it. The whole thing how this started out was an interview. A simple interview by this guy at Vancouver Film School. The simple thing. This is how it all started, this video. He told me that I still had 2 years to figure out who I was. But the funny thing is, I already found out who I want to be, and I want to go in that direction. And, I mean, I don't think he thought about that. I even told him about my YouTube career. I told him about that, and still yet he thinks that I haven't found myself. When I know deep down is that I want to be that person. I want to be in the film industry. I want to be that person that like half the people in the school be like, I went to school with that girl. I remember she dreamed about this moment. I want to be that person. I want to be that person no one can forget. I want to be that person that everybody knows. And that can put a large influence in the world through my future work. And I am willing to do that if you'll get me there. So that was my documentary. And by the way, this picture back here that was been staring at y'all kind of very creepy like. My art teacher, who was my biggest influence, him and I did this picture. He did half of the face and his hand, and I did the rest of it. So yeah, it's pretty cool. And that right there is by Katie. She's awesome too. So yeah, and he is my biggest influence. I even told him that he was my role model, and you know, yeah. So I hope you guys enjoyed the video. And I hope that this would inspire some of you guys. I sure hope it did. I really do. I really hope. So, yeah. I don't want to go before I babble on about something else not relevant to this topic. So, yeah. I'm going to go. Love you guys.